Return of the Living Dead, at the time, could you have ever envisioned it would become such a cult phenomenon and that it would have such a hardcore fan base that it does to date?
I'm totally shocked by the base, the horror base that it has like become, and it's a cult film. When we did it, we didn't think anything of it. We thought we were doing another horror film, and of course you don't see other actors doing their other things sometimes because you aren't in scenes with them. So we just thought, okay, we're doing a horror movie and it'll be out, you know, come and go. And that's when, because I loved horror myself, but then I discovered that there's a lot more people that love it too, which was great because I could meet them. But no way did I think it was going to be a cult classic and last this long. And I'm very sad because, you know, yesterday I was informed that James Caron died, and he was like a driving force because he was always positive, always upbeat, and he kind of like inspired you just to do more and be a better person too.
Are there particular memories that stand out most powerfully for you that make you smile the most, laugh the most, cry the most?
In Return of the Living Dead? Oh, my. Oh, I get... Okay, in the movie, when James Caron goes to the cremation place and he takes his ring off and they're playing that music, burn, you know? I don't know, that gets me every time. I get just like really like, oh, God, you know, because it's just like so horrible. And, you know, he's like, obviously a very happy married man, and he just does that. It just is sad to me. What stands out is the amazing effects they got, practical effects they did, like the woman, the split woman on the table. It's like, how did they do it? It's like an amazing thing. It's not CGI or anything. And also, just when I was in the mud and all the zombies were attacking me, I was very scared because extras tend to be a little overzealous. And I was like, oh, my God, everybody's going to want to be in the front and, you know, be seen. And I'm like, I'm going to, like, drown. So I was a little afraid of that a bit. And then also when I was buried for the resurrection, I had to like get down like in a yoga pose, and these people were, they actually buried me. They were taking shovels and burying me, and I couldn't breathe, and I had to kind of count in my head because they had to cue the rain machines, sound, and then action, and I couldn't hear. So I had to like in my head think, okay, when should I come up? Because I didn't want to do it again. And I didn't want to slip on the mud, so I'm like, okay, I've got to do it one time. So... that was kind of freaky.